One. So, Tony, you've had more than one career at Chesterfield. Would you like to tell us a bit about those?
Yeah, certainly. I mean, I signed for Chesterfield, 95, I bet. And then had four really good years at the club. Really enjoyed it. Obviously, we had the Wembley game. Was involved with the oil round for the semi-final as well. We got promoted. So all in all, in the time as a player, it was really good. Thoroughly enjoyed the club. And then obviously came back last season as the kit man, which was something, an opportunity I got from Chris and the gaffer, and something I thoroughly enjoyed as well, being involved with everybody, how it was run. It was a joy to be involved with, and obviously the goal at the end of the season was to get promoted, which we did, to go up as champions. Was a quite amazing 12-month period.
You've been almost a good luck charm then. You said, you know, back in the 90s as a player, and then on the staff as well, you've seen a lot of glory at Chesterfield.
Yeah, it was good. Yeah, I mean, it'd be nice to think I was a good luck charm, and they can always wheel me back in if they need some more. So, but you look at the 4 or 5 years I was here, there was 2 Wembley appearances, 2 promotions, and a cup run. So, yeah, it wasn't too bad, actually.
And so what are you up to these days, then?
Well, what I did was, obviously, at the end of the season, I decided to take 6 months out, following the cancer, and then obviously I got the all clear as well in July. So just at that time, I just wanted to take some time out, really, and just find out a little bit about myself, what I wanted to do, where I wanted to go. So really had a good think, or still having a good think about what's happening. But one of the things was I returned back to the gym, went to the gym, really needed to lose some weight and have a bit of a purpose, you see. And then, so I've been going to the gym for 3 or 4 weeks, and then decided I really needed now to, for motivation to keep going, was to get involved with something. And I got returned home one day from the gym. There was a newsletter from the cancer charity, and on the back was this Arctic adventure, a challenge of a lifetime. And it just ticked every box that I wanted to do and needed to do to really push forward, you see. So I've been training with that and really enjoying it. And I mean, can't wait till the end of January when I fly out.
So tell me, what exactly is this Arctic expedition?
Well, we fly out on the 30th of January, and then we land in the Arctic Circle in northern Sweden. So in the afternoon of the first day, we basically get used to sledding and looking after the dogs. So then from what you do is you basically start off and you go to a point. When you go to a point, you have to, the group of us will have to make sure that that's all prepared. We have to stay there for the night. We have to cook and feed ourselves while we're there. And also look after the dogs. So it'll be, so from that point of view, it'll be really, really good learning curve. The fact that you'll be in the Arctic as well, potentially seeing the Northern Lights, which is something I've always wanted to see and experience. And then the 3 full days you're there, you are sledding for around 7 hours a day, but you have to get from point to point. So once you reach your point, again, that's your bed for the evening. So you've got to sort out wherever you are, whatever needs doing. And then the last day, again, that's half a day. And then when you return, and then we get a return flight back into London. So all in all, it's 3 full days, 2 half days in the Arctic, and 2 half days travelling. So I think the response I've had from people as well has been really good, really positive. I can't quite wait, yeah.
So which charity is it that you're doing this for?
I'm doing this for the Lymphoma Association. I mean, obviously the reasons behind that was I was diagnosed with follicular lymphoma, which is cancer of the lymph glands, you see. And I just thought, well, this was an opportunity to give something back, you see. I see now that my life, or the rest of my life, is to help other people. And obviously the fact of giving something back. So I just thought, apart from it being a good opportunity for myself, it would be a good opportunity to raise some money for obviously a very, very good cause and a very, very good charity.
So you mentioned the gym before. How do you train for an Arctic expedition like the one you're going on?
Well, initially, I mean, I just wanted to lose some weight, and the excesses of the celebrations of winning the league and things like that put on a bit of weight. So initially, I was just doing some cardio and some weights. And then with the good help of Shane, the fitness guy, Shane's put a program together for 4 weeks, and then we will review that, and then there's another 4 week program to go after that. But initially, it's all about having strong arms, strong legs, and strong core, really. So he's put an unsympathetic training regime together, which builds my arms up, builds my legs up, and makes me strong for obviously for sledding. You see, so I'm incredibly grateful for Shane for doing that, because it's something I probably wouldn't have even dreamt of. So yeah, I've been really lucky with that.
So how are you feeling, you know, having a healthier body? How does that feel for you?
Well, this is probably as good as I've felt since I finished playing football, to be honest. I mean, in the summer I was probably the best part of 18 stone. Hopefully I'm down about 16 now. But it just gives you more energy, confidence. What it is now is the gym's become part of my life, so I can't imagine not going to the gym. I've had a massive change in my diet as well, again for the to help lose weight, but to keep the strength up for going to the gym, you see. So it's a massive change, but it's a change that I needed to do. It was a change that I really went in the comfort zone, as people would say. I went lazy and just ate what I want when I wanted, whereas now it's, I feel back as being a sports person again, which I've always been. And also what I want to do is, when I go and see and meet people, is to inspire them to do things, you know. So I can, part of my story is, 3 or 4 months ago I was 18 stone and now I'm down to the best part of 16. So
To have your friends and family reacted to your challenge?
Well, again, everybody's been a little bit surprised and maybe concerned, but everybody's been really, really supportive behind it. I think it's a great idea. I mean, I've had a lot of messages from the social media side as well. So, I mean, from my point of view, it's good, because you're doing something that everybody thinks is a good idea and you're getting involved with. And everybody likes to know, if you're doing something well, and everybody likes a bit of adulation, you see. So, no, I can't complain, but it's been a good journey so far.
Cool. So just under 2 months until the challenger gets underway. How are your emotions changing? Are you looking forward to it, or is it, are you starting to dread it a little bit?
No, well, at the minute I'm looking forward to it. And you're finding out things about it all the time, you know. Potentially you could get down to 40, minus 40 where we're going, you see. So thankfully, like the company that we're doing it through, they provide all of the clothes, you see. So it's not a case of me turning up in a Berghaus jacket or something like that and just trying to get away in a bobble hat. So we'll be prepared for it. We've got a meeting in a couple of weeks' time in London, where we go down and we're made aware of what needs to be done and what's happening and things like that. So so I think I am really excited for it, and you just need to keep that enthusiasm going.
Cool. And finally then, what can people do to help you out?
Well, there's a few things. I have a Facebook page, which I put a daily blog on, and writing is something that I've really enjoyed doing, probably the last 3 or 4 months. So it's probably not Charles Dickens, but what I try to do is write from the heart. So I've got a Facebook page, which is Frozen Nads for Nodes, which is a mouthful in itself. And then also I've got a Just Giving page, which is tony.lawmer1. So if anybody wants to donate, that'd be great. If anybody wants to leave me a message, then it's fantastic. The fact that a lot of people have followed the Facebook page and have donated is a massive motivation for me to keep going and carrying on, you see. So so yeah, if anybody wants to do that or anything, just get in touch, and You know, I think there's a company this morning rang me, and they've said that they want to give me a check, so I'm going to go and pick that up this afternoon. So yeah. Anyway, that other any areas. I mean, the club have said I could do a booker collection before a game in January, so hopefully we'll be doing something like that. So anyway, you know, money, notes, messages is fantastic, to be honest. So from what I'm doing, we want to try and build a business from it, you see.
Okay.
So what we're going to do is take what I'm doing now as a pilot scheme, mm-hmm. and then been working with a lady who understands business. So what we want to do is use my experiences here and then take that out into the business world and hopefully develop that, you see. So we've got, I mean, it's at the early stages at the minute, but we've got lots of ideas what we'd like to do. And so hopefully from what I'm doing now is something we can build on in the future, to be honest. So once I get back from once the challenge is finished, then in February, then we'll be launching something which will be hopefully quite exciting, to be honest.
Okay. And what will that be then?
Well, what it is, we've used my experience because at the time I was searching for things to do, you see. So what we're going to do is like a social enterprise, and we'll work with certain groups of people, individuals. So maybe somebody that, or people that are maybe out of work or have low self-esteem or lack of confidence and are just looking for something to do to get their teeth into, to get them up and running again. That's what we want to do, you see. So, so say somebody, I don't know, is out of work and can't get back into work but is looking for a path to go down. What we can do is get them to maybe pick a challenge and then use my pilot scheme of how I got fit to do this challenge, and then the social media side of things of building like a profile and then going into raising money for it. Then we can take them each step along the way, and then hopefully at the end of it they've got a good feeling about themselves, that they've done a challenge, they've raised some money for good cause, and obviously they feel an awful lot better for it. So